Keeter Sausage, some of the best sausage in the land. Let's check out Keeter's.
We got the gas grill going this morning. We gassing this morning. And we got our grill blasters on there. And the grill blasters are extremely hot right now, but they'll burn all the trash off your grill. Now, they've been on there a few minutes. It hadn't really started smoking yet. But we're going to take them off. I don't think there's much junk on there. A little bit. Yeah, it's all burnt up already. And we're going to get our... Now, we got a paper. I'm going to cut this thing off. And then... We've got a paper cleaner now instead of using a brush. And it's called Grill Scrubs. Grill Scrubbers. Groovy Scrub. Groovy Scrub. And as you can see, the grill blaster's got it already. Now, last time I used it, eventually it caught on fire. But, you know, if you come out here, use the grill blaster and let it cool off. These things here will be no problem. They got grooves in them that fit the grill. Everybody's going to these basic grates now. It's not like you got a whole bunch of different grates out there. Really, most of the gas grill lines are all the same. Yeah, it works. God, how could you get an organic grill scrubber? But there it is. You go on the front of Barbecue Superstars, you can buy these right now and get 10 of them. If the grill's cool, you can use them over and over again. Don't get a whole lot of water on them because they're paper, of course, but shoot, it works. Hey, if it works, it works. No more grill brush pieces in your grill. So we took half of the grill brush problem away by using grill blasters. Now we've taken the rest of it away by these organic groovy scrubs. Go on the front page of Barbecue Superstars, BBQ Superstars, and buy them right now. Did a good job. But you know, those grill blasters are the deal. They're the ones that do a good job. They really are good. Okay, today we're gonna introduce a new sausage. Fuckhead, stupid. All right, now we are back to all right, let's see now. We've got, I went ahead and got some Johnsonville sausage so we can check it. Got the Keeter Jalapeno sausage. We got the Keeter hot and spicy. Then we got Keeter traditional. And then we got Keeter green chili. And I was really impressed by the fact they got green chili and jalapeno, traditional hot and spicy. All right, we're going to start off by cutting up a little bit of green peppers and some onions. And then we got some mushrooms to go with it. I tell you, there's nothing better than eating a big sausage on a sub bun. Now, these are like small sub buns, but they make great hot dogs. Or oh, we got some, let's put these, I might cut them up a little bit more. Mushroom, and get onion. Really what I should have done, cut the onion up and cooked it for a while and then stuck that other in there. But There's all kinds of ways of dicing up onions. I need to get the onions on the bottom. The onions will take the longest to cook. I wish I had to put them in there first. Okay. Okay. Let's get the sausage out and see what they look like, and I'm gonna put them beside. Here's a jalapeno pack. Okay, so they're links. So they have got them in link form. I didn't know if they did or not. Look like all one piece. You can see the jalapeno in there. You almost wonder if you're using dyes in Johnsonville, because look how red they are compared to how gray these are. Now this might be chopped finer. Man, they got a smell to them, good smell. It also looks like they're hand packed for sure. These are definitely hand-packed. This might be natural, I don't know. Yeah, casings look the same. Of course, I can't tell the difference between natural and fake. You know, I don't know. There's the jalapeno. Yeah, that's some good sausage right there. It smells really good. Okay, here's jalapeno. little variation in sizes. Johnsonville's all the same size, but this longer one, I mean, that makes for a nice nice hot dog bun. This one here is a traditional sausage. This here's Johnsonville's original. This here is longer. I mean, it just would fit in the bun better. Okay, so this is the jalapeno, and this is the traditional. No, I'm sorry, this is hot and spicy. Shoot. Okay, well, you can see red. This here's got some green in it, and this has got red in it. These are the traditional, hot and spicy. Hot and spicy. Good Lord, let me get my mind on what I'm doing here. We'll have to see how they cook up against these brats. Johnsonville. Now we got the traditional right here. Man, that looks good. That's a big time sausage right there. We're gonna set them all in a row on the grill and see how they cook up. Alright, and then here's green chili. Jalapeno, hot and spicy, traditional. And now we got green chili. How many people sell green chili? And these are from Texas, so what they got ground up in here is real chilies. It ain't no chemicals. So are the jalapenos. In the hot and spicy, you can see the peppers in it. Green chili, baby! New Mexico style green chili sausage. Looking good, like a cowboy should. It's natural. No highly processed. Sausage. Now, folks, what would you rather go out to a tailgate with? I mean, let's get real with it now. Looks like we get down with it. Got the club coming. Everybody fixing to hang out. Got all these flavors of sausage here. Jalapeno, hot and spicy. Green chili, traditional. And then you got this little short thing. That looks good. Gotta wonder if ain't some dye in it or something. Johnsonville. Keeter, baby. Keeter means big time tailgating.
We're fixing to go over here and put these things on the grill and rock and roll just a little bit. Now, we got us a new seasoning we're working with. Elk Creek Beef Shake. Elk Creek Beef Shake. We're gonna have to bust open that Elk Creek after we get these bratwurst cooking. All right, let's get us some bratwurst on the grill. Man, that's one thing about a gas grill. You just hit it and it's lit. I'm gonna turn it all the way down. This thing cooks so hot. I tell you, these charbroil are cooking machines, big time. Okay, we're coming on here with the Okay, now we're coming with the okay, that's the jalapenos. That's got green in it. This is traditional right here. Okay, now we're coming with the hot spicy. They're kind of a reddish red color. Man, I'll tell you what I really like about these sausage. Natural. You can tell that's some guys who killed some hogs. And they putting some good tasting mixture together. They got some good sausage going on. Alright, now let's go with the You gotta. Onions and all that, cook it up. Nice smooth looking flavor coming off of there. Looking good, looking good. Like a cowboy should. Looking good, looking good. Hello. Hello. Oh, okay. Still trying to figure these cameras out this late in the game. Cooking up. We got a big one going. Rock and roll. Now, right now, as these bratwursts are cooking, because the lid is up, the heat's just going right through it. It's not reflecting down. It's not recirculating at all. Just going straight up through the brat, which means the bottom will get cooked but the top won't. But doesn't seem like we can see the cooking process that good if we put the top down. Now there's some people who just leave the put it on a topless grill and just go ahead and cook it. turn it up just a little bit, get them cooking a little faster. These ones across the front will cook faster than the ones in the back because there's a line of gas across the front on this grill. Okay, let's see which one starts cooking up first. Brat's got a little touch on them, but these are cooking across the bottom too. I bet you by the time they get going through the cooking process, the shape won't be much different. But now, I've got the buns. Got some great buns for cooking these things. That's a great size right there. Now that'll hold one of those. The length differences. Uh-oh, seen a little drip. Our vegetables are getting done fairly quickly. So we got the little guy, Keeters, competing against the big guy, Johnsonville. Now Keeters is getting a little juice coming out the top right there.
our brats are starting to cook up. Keeter got a little bit running out. Juicy, juiciness. Juicy, they're starting to stand up in the back too. Essentially, Johnsonville's never change. They look the same the whole way through the cooking process. So it's sort of like a cartoon, you know. You want it to look the same the whole time, there you go. Look at the juice coming out of the one in the middle right there. That's a traditional sausage. They all looking good. I ain't saying the Johnsonvilles don't look good. But okay. Boy, I tell you, those Keeters are getting round and standing up now, just like the Johnsonville, but they're bigger. I don't know if you can tell it, but every one of them is bigger than the Johnsonville. Johnsonville's got a standard, a good standard size. I got to give them credit for that. They're all the same. Turn some of them over. Oh, that's starting to get solid. I got Johnsonville ranked number one in the world, of course, because it's the number one sold brat in the world. But Keeter's got flavors. I know Johnsonville's got Italian and cheese. They probably got a few other flavors too, but we're talking about sausage from out of Texas, where green chilies come from, where jalapenos come from, and where they do everything big in Texas, so I imagine these hogs they used were probably really good. Of course, Texas is known for beef, not hogs. So they got that. Nice grill marks on them sausages. Ooh, they're good and solid. Solid. Whew, look at them sausage. My mom likes sausage. Keeters. Yeah. Johnsonville in the center. All sorts of flavored Keeters on the outside edge. Cook it up. Man, look at them jalapenos in there. Green jalapenos, you can see it. Bratwurst are getting done too. Boy, this grill cooks them beautifully. Really does a good job. I want to wish you all a happy Saturday. We've got some big games today. Carolina versus Clemson. Alabama versus Auburn, the Iron Bowl. All rivalry games are on today. Michigan versus Ohio State. Ohio State got beat by Michigan State, so they're out of the playoff picture. Man, that one there seems to be cooking up quick. Might have to be our first one we taste right there. They all blew up and got round. Yeah, it seems like they shrink it down just a little bit. Keeter sausage. Jalapeno green chili. Hot and spicy, traditional. Man, look at that Johnsonville blowing out a little bit up there. Wow. Look at all that juice. Man, this one here is just running with juice. And ones in the back are running with juice. Got a lot of juice in there. Boy, look at that thing just exploding. Now, as far as cookability, and cookability and the look of it, they're both the same. Now, all of Johnsonville sausages look exactly the same, which worries a little bit because what all are they putting in them to make them all look that same, you know? Seem like there have to be some kind of additives added in order to make them all look exactly the same as they cook through the process. What kind of R&D do they spend money on? What have they done? Gas burner on my grill might need to be cleaned. I love the way the grill's cooking them. It's just a nice little caramel color to it. I don't suggest you use your hands on the grill. Just doing it because it's easy and I want you to be able to see it good. That one there looks like it's done. It cooked faster than the Johnsonville. See, our sub bun is huge. Man, what a beautiful set of cooking right there. My bun's really too big for that one. I'm about to put a big one in, like this one. That one's a little longer. That's a nice one right there. That'll fit good in that bun. Keeter sausage. That's a jalapeno sausage. Green chilies. It's got green in it. That's really encouraging. That means it's all natural. It's not a chemical jalapeno flavor. It's a real jalapeno flavor. I'm not getting paid by either one of these guys, so I don't want you to think I'm just making this up because I'm getting paid. I'm not getting paid by, you know, barbecue superstars. We like to have integrity and do things because it's real, not because. We're getting paid by anybody. Whoa, look at there. Uh-oh. I have to go, well, yeah. Nah, we'll just put that in there because I'm gonna give this to my wife. Let me grab some mushrooms and green peppers and a whole lot of hell yeah. Stick it in there. Let's run her one in the house. Ooh, looking good. Well, we're definitely hotter in the middle. If I close the top, it would even the heat out all the way across, but you can't see what's cooking if I close the top, so you can tell that's a Keeter's. Put some of these on the edge in the middle. Pull some of these. Looks like they're about done. Now, the good thing about this, you put it up there and it'll still cook some, but it won't cook like, well, it might not cook much at all without the top down. Keep from burning up. Still taking a little time to cook the Johnsonville's been in the big heat. See, I don't think that thing's done still. These Johnsonville gonna take a little while to cook. Keeter's cook faster. I'm announcing that now. Keeter's cook faster. Definitely true. You want to get out there and get your tailgate on faster, get a Keeter's. Yeah, let's get some of these over here in this corner and put it in the center of the heat. And the problem is I'm putting one Johnsonville up here and I got four Keeters up there already. And it was in the center of the heat. Keeters cook faster. I'm dying to eat a Keeter sausage. I think I'm gonna eat this one. And I think I'm gonna eat this one. Uh-oh, a double Keeter, a double stacker. Need some mustard. Right, I'm sure that's what you're saying out there. You need some mustard on it. Really good as this food is. Keeter sausage, hell yeah. Ooh. Oh Lord, I'm gonna be full after these get done.
Whoa, man, that Keeter's is good. Here, Molly. Molly's my dog. I think I'm gonna let her have the Johnsonville. There you go, baby. You can have the Johnsonville.
Whoa. Keeters.
Jalapeno flavor coming through. It's not real hot, but it's got a little taste to it. Johnsonville got a lot of blowouts. They're blowing out all the juice. Blowing out. Keeter's just like slow roasting. Man, that jalapeno tastes like jalapeno. They good. K-E-E-T-E-R. Well, got a little blowout going there. Look at all that juice. Man. Juicy. Keeter double barrel. Green chilies. Boy, you know that one's good. I'm surprised at how strong the flavoring is in it. I guess it's because they're using real ingredients. Ain't no additives.
the real deal. Man, mushroom's good in this situation too. Was it good? Okay. I gave her one of the hotter ones. I had to come in to get me a big glass of water. Yeah, I got a jalapeno. That was a jalapeno. Well, get on the live stream thing. Doesn't matter if this event's over or not. Cast your vote for Johnsonville or Keeter's. Right now, I'm on Keeter's side. I gave my Johnsonville to my dog. Keeter's are very flavorful. Green chili. I gotta eat one of them green chili sausages. The jalapeno was so good. I don't think I'm gonna eat all the bread. I think I'm just gonna eat the sausage. Boy, that's nice and good and round. Great consistency as far as the problem with Johnsonville's that I see, the only really main problem with them is they just take too long to cook. They're, and you know, you gotta wonder if it's done even when you think it's done. They're difficult to get done. Now this 100% natural out of Texas Keeter's, you could tell, I mean, boom, it's cooking all the way through. I think it has something to do with the shell. Also, the way the Johnsonville's blowing up, I mean, there's something added. There's water added, something to make it keep that perfect round shape. They're selling visual as well as content. And I'm not as worried about visual as I am flavor. And that green chili, you know that's a hell yeah.
Okay, let's get us a green chili right here. I'll move that one over. Oh, that's a pretty sausage. It's long. Yeah, and a green chili right there. Can you see that green? Substantial difference in the flavor. You know, you can get a Johnsonville, it'll say cheese on it, but by the time you cook it and everything, you can't taste no cheese. I'm completely cooked on this thing and I can taste the green chilies in it big time. It's good too. Man, that's good. Texas and New Mexico, especially the western side, are hard places to live. Everybody out there eventually has to be a cowboy. But the food coming out of there has changed the world. Oh Lord, that's ridiculous. Man, that's good. Blowout. Get the hoe out. We got a blowout. Feeny. 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 See, I don't know. It's too damn big. I don't know if that's finished or not. Good one way, oh boy, it's still big, but the other way, is it raw in the middle? Let's do a test. You've seen that the Keeters were completely done. Let's do a test and see if the Johnsonville's done.
Damn.
Honestly, that don't look like it's completely done. That's the problem that Johnsonville is trying. Oh, see, it's not done. That is not done. It's still not done. Sure ain't. They've been on the grill the same amount of time. That one stayed in the main part of the heat. Keeters is long since done. You can see a difference in them. I could actually see some raw meat in that Johnsonville. You know, looking here at it live, it's still light. Keeters, long since done. All right, www.keeters.com, Keeters. Traditional green chili. German brand sausage made in the USA. All natural. Smoke flavor added. Minimally processed. Contains no artificial ingredients. No MSG, no sodium, no nitrate. Natural smoke flavor. Hell yeah. Well, I don't know what you think, but when you go do your next tailgate, go to the Keeter's website. He sent these overnight. Next day air, they were frozen when they got here, and they had to wait a day. Very, very effective packaging. That's tailgate heaven right there. Keeter sausage. Ah, dang, there is a big difference. Here, Molly, here's another piece of Johnsonville. That Keeter's is just good. All right, we're going to put this on the Barbecue Superstars cooking channel. I got 5 cameras peeled down on this Keeter's Johnsonville comparison. We'll put us a nice show together to let you see it. Elk Creek, award-winning blend. SCA. Steak shake. Beef shake. Beef, pork, chicken, and game. Elk Creek. Looking good. Elk Creek barbecue. Here, Molly, here's another Johnsonville. I know you. It's hot. All right, Daryl Barbecue Superstars, y'all have a good day.